If you totally, okay, understood this, you need to prepare. Hindi ho pwedeng magpapadala-padala lang kayo ng claim na hindi ninyo hinanda yung pag-ayos ng claim ninyo. Okay? So, kailangan ho malinis ang pag-prepare ng claim ninyo. So, okay, nandyan na yung process natin. So, after all of those things, I will now list to you yung mga do's and the don'ts in preparing yung claim ninyo for medical audit. Okay? So, ito po, number one. You need to accept and you need to understand na si PhilHealth po insurance lang talaga. Okay? Now, dahil insurance lang siya, ang impact ho talaga is ganito. Okay? Yung logic dyan is, at times, a lot of hospitals argue and at times, a lot of hospitals get mad kasi ho, there is this imbalance between financial aspect and the clinical aspect of the claim. Okay? So, marami ho yan, yung tipong, why are they evaluating the claim? Sino ba sila? Ako naman yung espesyalista. Ako naman yung nakakita ng pasyente. Okay? Legitimate yan. Tama ho yun. Okay? Now, kailangan lang hong i-review ni PhilHealth yung claim ho ninyo kasi nga, to guarantee that before getting paid, yung quality aspect nandyan. Okay? Take note ha, ang binayad sa CAPMR, 25 billion ba yun? Something. Unlucky ho. So, ganito, with the amount of money being spent, with the amount of money being paid to the healthcare providers, okay, there will be no balance between financial and the clinical. It will always lean to the financial. Okay? Ulitin ko ha. With the amount of money being spent, with the amount of money being paid to the hospitals, ito hong balancing ng financial and clinical, at times this will not happen. It will always lean to the financial. Ganito, example. Alam ba ng mga taga PhilHealth na hindi lahat ng CAPMR kailangan talaga ng X-ray? Okay? Meron, pwede naman wala eh. I can manage that. True. You can manage it. But if the government is paying 25 billion for a specific span of years, okay, they will compel everybody to submit checks X-ray whether you like it or not just to guarantee that the money being spent, okay, is done with quality care. They don't care about your opinion. Kaya ang sinasabi ko sa kliyente ko, wag na ho kayong makipagtalo kasi they will always lean for the financial. If the budget of UHC is 200 billion, 300 billion, 400, it keeps on increasing because ang bayad natin sa premium keeps on increasing. So the budget on UHC is also increasing. And the amount of money being spent for paying your services, okay, is very critical. So when hospitals or doctors demand, ano ba yung mga sepsis? Humihingi pa kayo ng blood culture. Hindi ba nila alam na pwede namang hindi blood culture lang? Hindi ko kinuna ng blood culture yan kasi iba yung ginawa ko. True, pwede ho yan. You can do it, you can use other things. That is very valid. But the amount of money involved in paying sepsis is quite huge. So they will demand it whether you like it or not because it's not only for you. Because they want to guarantee that money is used properly. They will not exempt you kasi malaking trabaho ho yan. Okay? Ganun ho yung perspective ng gobyerno kasi pera din nyo yan eh. Pag naubos yan, magagalit kayo sa kanila. Yeah. Ano ba yung kalokohan ni PhilHealth? Ito, pangatlo. Ang mga taga-PhilHealth, kalokohan. Eh, moderate dehydrated talaga yun eh. Eh, kasalanan ko ba? Wala nang pang-fecalysis. Hindi ninyo bayaran? Tama nga naman yun, clinically. Pwede ho yan, clinically. But the amount of money being spent, okay, for the entire country, for paying AGE moderate dehydration, is so enormous, okay, to guarantee that money is not wasted, okay, they will require everybody to submit fecalysis. If you cannot submit one, they don't actually care. Ulitin ko ha, they don't give a damn kung hindi ka makasubmit. Sorry, we will not pay you. You are not exempted. Because para sa kanila, meron hong mga fraudulent talaga. If the moment they will exempt you, kailan ho hihinto yung mga exemption? Yan ho yung perspective nila. Sa kanila, checklist lang eh. I-comply mo yung checklist. Ang hinahanap ko, quality. Sundin mo yung CPG. O, nakasulat sa CPG, di ba? Fecalysis. E, nagkataon, hindi nakaproduce ng tae. E, valid nga naman yun. But for them, the amount of money that is being consumed for AGE is too enormous. Okay? Wherein a lot of them will say, I'm sorry, but I don't care. So, ganun ho yun. Okay? Kaya sinasabi ko sa mga kliyente ko sa masterclass, okay? There's no balance between financial and clinical. Sa perspective ho ng mga taga-insurance, it's always financial. Yan ho yung priority. Though they will not actually neglect, they will not consider, but at the end of the day, they will decide in favor of the financial. Kasi pera ng taong bayan yun eh. And they can be easily crucified if the money will be depleted. Okay? So, that's number one. Okay? Ulitin natin ha. Accept and understand that PhilHealth is insurance and there is a specific mindset. When there is an issue of balancing the financial aspect versus the clinical, there is no balance. It will always lean to the financial aspect. Okay?